Everybody, it's Invicta. It's time to continue All Items Taken Week here on the channel. Happy Friday, everybody. Man, oh man, are we all recovered from whatever yesterday's crazy episode was? Talk about chaotic, man. I don't even know what was going on in my head yesterday, but we did have another video cross 5,000 likes. Thank you all very much. I have a very special offer to you all, which I'll talk about later on in this video. Don't worry, it's not a sponsored thing or anything. I'll tell you in a little bit after we do the intro. And of course, speaking of intro, here's your meme of the day. This one brought to you by Potential Agio or Adagio. Title thread was, he was not putting up with any nonsense. Straw man takes old bandage. Invicta, yeet! I mean, hey, look, I didn't give you permission to take it, so I don't know what to tell you. So 214 over 240 for All Blind Items Week, which I'm looking forward to as well. But we got to finish All Items Taken Week first. And okay, see, today's going to be Golf November. Mike Papa, Mike for Papa Yankee. We're starting off with Spoonbender, and also it's a Curse of the XL. And on top of that, we also have Monster Manuel, which gave us, I believe, Seraphim. Yes, that would have been real bad there if we didn't have enough Tears Right to actually stop the double troll bombs. But yeah, yesterday's video, man, was something else. Like I said, it was going to be chaotic, and boy, howdy, was it ever. Today, well, I don't know, we might be seeing considerably less chaos. Of course, we got to be careful here with one HP start. But yeah, going over the offer, I wanted to give a little spice, a little incentive for the mosh pit here as we close out All Items Taken Week for tomorrow. If this video gets 8,000 likes, we're going to keep it reasonable. 8,000 likes is something that mosh pit is capable of very easily. If this video gets 8,000 likes, I will be doing a very special type of run to close out All Items Taken Week. And it is, I don't want to give too much away other than saying that it'll be the run that people have been waiting for. Let's put it that way. Because, I mean, let's be real here. All Items Taken Week, we haven't really had that many problems. You know, we had a couple really solid runs, actually. Outside of yesterday's run being just the chaotic whatever it was. You know, we had a great Tainted Eve run. We had a Binge Eater run. You know, we had all sorts of just great runs. And it hasn't really been all that challenging. But obviously, there's not much I can do about it. I mean, hey, it's all RNG at the end of the day. If the game just wants to be nice, I ain't going to stop it. But I figured why not close out the week here and close out the challenge with something special. And I figured that, you know, let's throw a little spice into it. So if you all get this video to 8,000 likes, this one, the one that you're watching right now, to 8,000 likes, then I will be doing a very special run to close out All Items Taken Week on Saturday. And we'll give it till Sunday as well, because it is going on into the weekend. So you have until Sunday, until the next random run day, the end of All Items Taken Week. We'll do a very special run here. So speaking of special run, there's the entire map with us running back and forth here. I was really just looking for the shop and the other item room here, game. So Spoonbender, of course, gives us homing shots, which are going to be very, very useful. We've actually gone through so many rooms. We now have three charges on the... we've used three charges on Monster Manuel. That's how many rooms we've cleared. Oh my goodness. Well, I'd say it was definitely worth it. Unfortunately, we can't go into the curse room unless the secret room is above this next room over here. Yeah. Which it is not, because it's blocked by rocks there. I'm not sure where the secret room is, actually. Can't be there. We've already tried. Well, we didn't try there technically, but I mean, you know, we got a troll bomb there. It's gonna be famine. Who I'm not really feeling here as our first boss, as we do get an orbital, which does basically theoretically nothing. It doesn't help our stats out in any way, shape, or form. But with Cricket's Head here, we should be able to dispatch anything that we see early on. We get Matchbook, and surprisingly did not give us a single troll bomb. Very proud of you, game. I'm still not going to go into the cursed room, though, because I kind of value these soul hearts. Obviously, we can't go into the devil. I mean, we could go into the devil deal, but there's no real reason to. We can't realistically take a devil deal item. Not sure where our super secret room is. There's a lot of... I mean, on an XL floor, it's definitely difficult, so... Ooh. Now, we can go down to one half heart here. Or, sorry, one black soul heart. All right, so we're going to head on down. Ooh. Placebo, about the most underwhelming item that you could have gotten, except with the exception of maybe Straw Man, I guess, from a lover's card. A reverse lover's card will basically use, it's basically like magic skin, except not as bad as magic skin. It takes away one red heart container or two soul hearts and gives you an item that is based on the loot table that you're currently in, of the room that you're in. So we had a secret room item, and we got placebo, which is like, you know, dog dookie, but hey, you know, I mean, we are taking, all right, never mind, just kidding. Oh no. Well, we get shoot to whoop. So we don't have to worry about placebo anymore, but what we do have to worry about is cursed penny. Perks. So cursed penny will teleport us every time we pick up a coin. Well, it has a chance to teleport us anyway. You gotta be careful here. Obviously, we're on 1 HP, so caution is the key. Caution is the key word of the day. I need to remember that we have Cursed Penny, by the way, Brain. Have you seen this? Have you heard about this? We have Cursed Penny, by the way, Brain. That teleports us every time we pick up a penny. So if there's a penny that drops, don't pick it up until after we're done going to the rooms that we need to go into. Okay, got it. Good. All right. Could save ourselves a key. Can you tell it? I haven't picked up Cursed Penny in a while. Okay. Brain, we're going into the item room. We are going into the item room. Okay? We will not pick up any pennies. We will not do it by reflex. We will not do it by any way, shape, or form. We are just simply going to the item room, Brain. You got it? All right? No more brain farts, okay? Because we've had to do a reverse full clear here just to get back to where we were. Okay. Sweet. Awesome. Get Data Miner. Data Miner is certainly an item that exists in the Binding of Isaac. And I wouldn't mind PH Dizzle, I'm going to be honest. Some people might. People might call that a cop-out, but I say give me PH Dizzle. I'm gonna save ourselves some time here. I'll continue to hold on to the cursed penny, but I'll drop it if there's multiple like coins in here. Like, I mean, I purposely bombed the donation machine. I'll take PH Dizzle. We can't go back and take placebo. Hey, we got a shot. Shot speed up. We could get these bombs here. Speed up. Okay, we got rid of the cursed penny. Thank God. Okay. Now remember, we're still on 1 HP here, so we're not exactly safe. Our damage can keep us safe for the most part, but we need to be cautious. I wouldn't mind getting a good Angel Deal item. You know, the Ipecac Godhead item or run was certainly... It was underwhelming, I think, is the best way to describe that. We ended up getting Super Bandage, which is going to give us some HP. And we get Pascal's Candle, Pascal Candle, which also kind of gives us a Tears Rate upgrade, I guess. So the candle, essentially what happens is every room that we clear that we don't take damage in, we will get a tears up to a maximum of, I don't know what the cap is. And then as soon as we take damage, that bonus is gone. I'm going to bomb the judgment and the... There we go. If Probably could have actually played that instead of bombed it, but yeah. Okay. All right. Let's go. We got a decent chance for an angel deal here. A little bit worried about what we find in here. Okay. Well, until we get flying, we unfortunately can't get those chests. Or if we get some kind of invincibility, that would also be fine. Data miner. If we end up using data miner, it will shuffle all of our stats, but also completely screw up everything. And that's almost literally what the tooltip in the game says, except like, you know, it's got profanity in it, so I'm not gonna say it here on YouTube. I gotta be a little family friendly and everything. But if you want the uncensored version of Zinvicta, go to twitch.tv/Zinvicta right now. Well, not right now, because I'm not gonna be streaming, but you know. We got our soul heart back, thankfully. Would like to know where our secret room is. All right, I absolutely hate this room. Luckily, our movement speed is augmented by a Liberty Cap here, so makes the room a little bit more tolerable. Hit the intruder, which is going to give us a quad shot, and every now and then, if we do take damage, which will be probably pretty often, we are going to have a little. There's a little bit of, little follower that follows us around. If you remember, not Wilson, but what was the name? What was the name of that? Weber from Don't Starve. Kind of reminds me of that. I shall buy the broken watch because we can afford it at least. One more cent, we can get the soul heart, which I definitely would not mind. I think I may have overdone it. A little bit. Oh my goodness. Okay. I think I may have overdone it on KBBQ tonight. I never thought I'd say this, but I think I'm actually like baconed out. It's weird, right? Cause oh my. Did you see the speed that freaking Mullaboom was moving? This is why we don't take the broken stopwatch, by the way. Anyway. Yeah, we went to a Korean barbecue, and they don't typically serve bacon. But the place that we went to tonight, they added something new to the menu. And I was like, I like pork belly. Like, pork belly is real good. But they added this new item that was, like, thinly sliced pork belly. And I was like, I was sitting there thinking about it, and I'm like, with a slightly confused look on my face, I was like, isn't that just bacon? Is it thinly sliced pork belly just bacon? And so, out of curiosity, of course, me and my friends ordered it, and sure enough, it was bacon. It was a legit bacon as bacon can be, and man, it was good. I don't remember exactly how many that we ordered, but it's an all-you-can-eat Korean barbecue place. I don't know if they're all like that or not. Another movement speed here, and we get home. Boy, alone delirium. That's just super great. Yeah, the movement speed. Or, broken stopwatch proc'd in there, so yeah. Eh. If you're wondering why our stats went up like crazy right there, it's because Liberty Cap proc'd Magic Mush in that room. So anyway, so, yeah, I don't know how many, I'm not sure how many plates that we ordered. It was over four. I know that. And on top of that, like, all we had tonight was the thinly sliced pork belly, and we also had beef belly, which is, like, my number one favorite thing to get at Korean barbecue now. Or has been for a while now, I should say. But, like, I started feeling not great when I got back home, and I was like, man. And one of my friends, she mentioned bacon, like she was craving bacon. I was like, this might be the first time in my life. I think I'm baconed out. I never thought I'd say it, but man, I like the thought of even the smell of bacon right now would just, I don't know, man. Like I wouldn't be able to make it. And so that got me thinking, because I always thought the bacon, and I still maintain that bacon is still, like, the best overall taste that you can possibly have. You know, like peanut butter and chocolate's real good, don't get me wrong. But bacon is bacon. I mean, bacon's real good. But I just realized that after tonight, I'm like, I can't eat bacon. I wouldn't be able to eat all. Like, I actually got sick of it. Like, I still feel, like, not great right now. Get Linger Bean here. So it got me thinking. I was like, so what is the... Is there a food that exists right now in the world that I'd be able to eat without having any problems just eating it for the rest of my life? I'll take Sackhead here. And I was like... I started thinking, like, well... Maybe like you would think, of course everyone knows I'm a big steak guy. You know I like my steak. I like beef, right? But I can't do beef all the time. I would get sick of it. And I was like, I'm not a big pork fan outside of bacon, you know. And by the way, this hypothetical situation is based on us not having any health problems. I use data miner. I'm just gonna start using data miner on every cooldown. We'll see how dumb our stats can get. So I was like, yeah, I don't think I can do steak 24/7. I'd get real tired of it. And I was like, what food could I do if not steak and not bacon? And I was like, I started to like expand my horizons. Again, this hypothetical is based on the assumption that we're not going to suffer any fatal or any health problems for the long term. This is just a fun hypothetical. I was like, man, could I do like sour candy all the time? Because I love sour candy. And assuming that like my teeth wouldn't just, you know, just fall out because of the pure battery acid that you're eating and all the sugar, you know, would I be able to do that? And I was like, no, no, I can't. I don't think I'd be able to do it. I think that it would just get boring after a while. But then sour candy, I was like, okay, I was like, let's simplify it a little bit more. What about just fruit? I was like, maybe bananas. I might do some bananas like 24/7 as long as like I didn't die from a fatal potassium overdose or whatever, you know, how deadly bananas are. So I think bananas are definitely up there. And then like strawberries, like I could probably do strawberries forever. Like I love strawberries. I definitely could do apples. Oranges, absolutely not. Apples, absolutely not. I can't tell if we're gaining damage or losing damage with data miner. But it's definitely screwing everything up. So I've not found the item room yet. We're on pace for boss rush if we keep on going here. Okay. I wouldn't mind taking the Bible just to get rid of data miner so I can stop using it. No tenant skull in here, unfortunately. So yeah, so I think bananas would probably be up there. And then I was like, if we're talking about food, like just food, like consumable food, like as in like anything that we eat or drink is considered food, then like maybe milk. Like I really love milk. Like just regular plain old skim milk or like 1%. I can do 1% milk on occasion, but I prefer skim milk. No, I'm all for it. I'm right there with you. Dead bird, the man, the bird, the legend. We just continue to gain damage here. Still looking for the tinted skull, which we've not found yet. By the way, every time you use data miner, it will not only randomize your stats, but also like make all the sprites kind of messed up. However, you can't use data miner to get like around like a dead end. Like it won't, just because it removed like a barrel on your way or a steel block, that it's still there. Just visually, it's not there anymore. We're gonna have to go through every single room before we find our tinted skull, aren't we? You're gonna make me go through every single room, aren't you? A magician card, which I don't want. Okay, there you go. I'll take the I'm Drowsy pill just to have it with us. don't think I've ever seen the tinted skull inside of an XL room. I think it's always been on a regular sized room. It's probably done deliberately so the skull doesn't spawn somewhere that's inaccessible to the player, but I wouldn't put it past Isaac at this point. We all know how it goes, you know what I mean? Got movement speed and lost a lot of range. And Mustode is looking for that there tinted skull, so we don't have to do boss rush. But as luck would have it, it's in the only other room that we have not been in. Actually, no, it's not. I don't know where it is then. We've seen it at some point. I didn't register my brain because I was probably talking about infinite food. I think this is the room that we're getting hit a whole bunch in. That's the reason why I didn't register. Didn't register in the old noggin. Yeah, what foods do you think you could eat infinitely without having a problem? Assuming that there's no bad health benefits. Disadvantages. Adverse health effects. I think we gotta go Holy Light here. We don't have enough money to make Stairway possible. I'm done with Dr. Fetus. I'll take Bozo just for the Soul Heart. We had enough of Dr. Fetus in the Megaton episode, I think. Lost shot speed and we gained luck. An H machine? There was not. I mean, perks is really good too. We could use that against Lamb if we need to. We'll enjoy the damage of the negative. I'm like, man, like maybe fried chicken? Like, how specific are we talking about? Just any food? I've already established that chicken is an S-tier meat. Like, for me, it's number one. Chicken is the number one meat. I'm a big fan of fish. I do like me some steak. But, like, when I think about the meat that I eat overall, like, just more than anything else, it's got to be chicken. Has to be chicken. This is so versatile and just so good. Although I will say that, and I don't know if any medical experts in the mosh pit want to help out, but if I eat chicken by itself, like if I just eat chicken just by itself without anything else, no sides, no nothing, no, not even bread, I get like kind of nauseated. I don't know if that's I'm not sure if that's like a common thing. If there's some kind of chemical or protein or enzyme or something, and I usually only eat white meat, so you know, I like me some chicken breasts, but like I gotta eat something with it, like otherwise I feel sick, like I feel very nauseated. There's the entire map, by the way, everyone, in case you're wondering. So I don't know if that's like a medical. If that's just an abnormality, or if I'm just weird, or you know, if that's a thing that does happen to people, I'm probably just weird. Sun card. I want to save our perks here just in case. Remember, if this video gets up to 8,000 likes or more by the start of Sunday, then I will be doing a very special conclusion to All Items Taken Week. And for what I have in mind, it's gonna be something, all right. Definitely something that the people have been wanting. for this week, because, I mean, again, you know, this week hasn't really been all that challenging, but that just, I mean, that's just the nature of it when it comes down to RNG. You know, if we just get good runs, I mean, you know, it's been a good week of runs. Finally get a tiers upgrade here as we continue to use Data Miner, and we got just nothing in here. We did get Cuppy's Paw, which means that I'm free from having to use Data Miner again. We'll head on to Zown. Yeah, between all the pork belly and all the beef belly, man, my stomach is like, it's a lot of fat to intake. A lot of fat and a lot of protein. But it was good. It was so good. I wouldn't have kept doing it if it wasn't good. Just like the thought of bacon right now just repulses me. Which is good. I mean, I'm glad. I'm glad that I have a limit, right? Like, I'm someone who frequently has problems with limits. On I like to enjoy stuff in excess. You know, if I like something, I really like something. Like, I like. You know, what's the latest thing that I was really super into, still am into right now. You know, it's like I get if I find something that really grabs my interest, like a particular game, like Tiny Folks, for example. There you go. There's a good one. Tiny Folks is doing, you know, not super great on the channel, but not bad enough yet to relegate it to the second channel. We have a stretch goal over there as well, if you didn't know. Anyone who wants to see the Tiny Folks series turn into a full-blown, like, we're just going to finish the run, 1,000 likes on those videos. So far, the Mosh Pit's been doing pretty steady on those, and I'm really, really happy to say that. You know, throwing stuff like that into the mix of the content creation stuff, it's in one way I don't like doing it, in one way it's necessary. I don't like kind of fishing for likes and that sort of thing, but it is necessary for a channel's health and survival on YouTube. That's just how the game is played. You know, and I try to be as completely honest with people as possible when it comes to that sort of thing. I don't think this is going to be the Ultra Seeker room, but I'm going to use it anyway. Probably not a wise thing to do in Shoal now that I think about it. Yeah, having that kind of incentive with your audience and the audience actually like coming through with it is huge for any channel. Doesn't matter what size. There's little incentives, big incentives. It all goes a long, long, long way to creating a successful YouTube channel. Secret room? It's secret room. And you know, you'd be surprised at how well people respond to it. You know, I've already had people in the comments say like, "Hey, thanks for reminding me to like the video." It's, you know, even though you may not think it's necessary, it actually does remind me to click the like button. I appreciate that. You know, I'm glad that kind of stuff is working, because it does help the channel. And I really, really like Tiny Folks. It's a great game. Those of you who, if you've been sleeping on those episodes now, I don't want to say series yet, but if you've been sleeping on Tiny Folks, you need to definitely at least check out episode 1. And for every video that gets, you know, that gets a thousand likes, we'll continue it. I'd love to at least do one full run. That'd be neat. Emperor card. I mean, the Emperor card is technically better here for us than the perks, because I mean, it takes us straight to Lamb. Broken stopwatch, helping us out for once. That's not true. It's procced a couple of times, in the good way. Broken stopwatch either makes things really, really fast or really, really slow. In case you didn't realize that. Secret room should be right here. There's not. Actually surprised by that. The luckiest host right there. I think this is Red Gate. The kind of metal. People have been asking me when is the new Word of Lauder stuff coming out. Mark and I are still working on... We have three songs cooking right now. We've also been writing stuff for Matthias and I's, our project, which we still... We do have a band name. We have a project name and everything. We just haven't announced it yet. Luckily for us, Broken Stopwatch did proc in here. I can't even begin to guess the timing on this. It's way slower than the regular stopwatch. This is like stopwatch plus like spider bite. But yeah, we've been writing new music consistently, and for the Word of Lauder and Planet Ridiculon crossover collab, whatever you want to call it, our collaborative effort, our new band. We've also been writing tracks for that as well, which we hopefully will have something. Matthias is out of town basically right now. He's basically like, he's not on tour, but he's traveling. Let's put it that way. When he gets back, it's going to be just full bore, just all going full ham there. So stay tuned for that. I'll take 9 lives because we just basically get that right back. And, yeah. I was really hoping that he wasn't going to do that because I wanted to hold our tears up from, a candle. I guess I should feel lucky that at least like the Broken Stopwatch didn't give us the speed or give him the speed boost. Yeah, there's our little Weber guy from the intruder. There we go, and yeah, we'll do a victory lap, why not? Second seed, Echo 8, Lima Delta, 3-2, Zulu 3. Definitely not going to go on any insane, like, extended run today. Yeah, we're just chilling. We're just having a fun time. We have Parasitoid, an excellent S-tier support item here. Much like the Mulligan, it's going to give us attack spiders and flies every time. Well, potentially every time one of our tiers makes contact with an enemy. I think the secret room's here, but I'm not 100% sure. Okay. That was just too tempting. I had to run Larry down. Now I kind of wish that we had taken the stairway. Oh yeah, we have more options. Options, by the way, was that item that I just got done buying in the store, and what it will do is it will, whenever there's a consumable that drops, it's gonna drop a second one. And you will have the option, like I keep screwing up, you'll have the option to take one or the other. If you take one, then the other disappears. We get a nice tiers upgrade here with soap, and we get Swarm Protector, which is, man, really disappointing Angel Deal items here, except for Holy Light and the Stairway. Let's go back here and take a look for our them there item room. I am going to go in the Curse Room because we are 2 of 3 for Guppy, so we might as well. Let's find the store. We got 22 cents, so we can afford one premium item. Eh. I think we can do better. As luck would have it, the last place we go to is going to be our item room. Secret room is guaranteed to be right there. We get the swallowed penny. Gets rid of our flat penny. But 28 keys. We should probably, like... We should probably utilize some of these keys here. Why not? All right, key beggar. I never, ever, ever play you. Okay, and there we go. Got Beelzebub, so that gave us flying at least. And we'll take it. We will head on down. Yeah, we could play Judgment, but I'd rather save it for a premium item. I bought one of those standing fans, like those tower... You know which ones I'm talking about, like the tower fans that you get for offices. And man, it is an absolute godsend. Like, S-tier quality purchase right there. And I know there's one of you out there... I know there's one of you out there who's been on the fence, and be like, wow, you know, I really, really do need one of those tower fans, but I'm just not... I'm unsure. I really need someone to tell me, like, give me a heads up. I don't know if they're worth it or not. I know you're out there. You exist. At least one person out there in the mosh pit has been debating on whether or not they should get a standing tower fan. And let me tell you something, brother or sister. It's a good buy. It's a game changer because, like, it gets hot in my office. I mean, the computer puts out a pretty good amount of heat. The being in front of the monitors, like having two monitors just looking right at you, like they put out heat, you know, I got lights and stuff. So like it gets hot in here, and having just a little slight breeze. And by the way, I keep my house cool, like really, really cool. I have to be comfortable. I'm miserable if I'm super duper hot. There's a penny in there. Let's go back and get that because we have Keeper Sack now, which will give us a soul heart here and a 0.25 range upgrade. All right. So yeah, so this is your boy Sinvicta's message to you all. If you've been on the fence, about buying a standing tower fan for your office, do it. Just do it. Double black Monstro goes down in a hurry. We get Cat of Nine Tails. Oh, baby. I also get Revelation. How long has it been since we've seen Revelation? I feel like it's been a minute. Revelation and Cricket's Head. Sign me up. Oh, that's right. We have Spoonbender as well, so we have homing on Revelation. That right there is amazing. Does the Eternal Heart. We do actually have Friend Ball as well, which I haven't been utilizing. Thought I could catch one of them. And Host Hat. Host Hat's going to give us Blast Resistance, aka Bomb Resistance, and allow us to not take damage from bombs at all. And on top of that, it's going to give us a nice little Host Hat that kind of pops out every now and then and does kind of nothing, but sometimes it does. Sometimes it does something, as you see right there. Exercising our bomb resistance. Take pay to play, gives us a movement speed upgrade, damage, and range from Keeper Sack. Super Secret Room guaranteed to be right there. I will blow up the Charge Beggar. It's worth a pretty good amount of extra Devil Deal chance or Angel Deal chance. We actually get a Devil Deal chance here. I'd love to get Guppy. Say goodbye to the Paul Penny. And we do get Guppy. And we might as well take Duality as well. Oh, man. We are absolutely crushing this run. I mean, this is kind of how most of the week has been. Which I know may not be what everyone was hoping for. I know everyone loves to see me struggle, and they like to see the strategies come out whenever we're having a rough go at it. But hey, look, the game delivered it. I just signed for it, baby. That's all I'm doing. Don't care about the Mega Troll Bomb. Now, if you're wondering why the chest looks like that, it's because we took pay to play. So keys are no longer necessary. And it's really, really nice whenever you have Guppy's tail. Get a stars card. We can use that to get out of the boss rush. Marrow and another Eternal Heart, man. HP is just dropping like crazy. Don't know where our secret or our item room is. What is this? Chaos card. I'd have the stars card. Secret room could be here. Again, we have plenty of keys, so all right, key judgment. Here we go. Let her rip. All right, there we go. Moving on. Vested here. We don't need to go in the curse room, but I'm going to anyway. Tears up.
Tears up.
Or Babylon, which I will take, just because it's a pretty decent damage up. Fortunately, we can't buy Monster Manual. If you're wondering why we had a money deal, a devil deal, it's because we have the Keeper's Bargain trinket right now, which sometimes makes it to where the devil deals do cost money instead of HP. We're moving way too fast there. Once again, the last room we go to is the item room. Oh, good God. All right, well, things just took a very explosive turn for the worst. As we have Ipecac now, which, you know, 81 damage is pretty good. It's all right. You know, we could be better. But the problem is that we've got Revelation, you see. And Revelation, much like Brimstone, it explodes when it procs. Or should I say it more accurately, it explodes whenever it fires. See right there. So while it does deal a great amount of damage, it renders Revelation completely useless. Like, I mean, well, actually, no, I take that back. We have Host Hat. Never mind. Host Hat is one of those items. It's much like PhD. It's much like Pyromaniac. It's one of those items that, like, because I don't see it, it's not readily, like, visible. I always forget about it. Oh, man. Tier Detonator is going to be something else. Yeah. Tier Detonator is going to be a menace. Yeah, so I briefly forgot that we had Host Hat. Never mind. Ipecac is going to be huge. It's going to be absolutely massive. And Tier Detonator making even more tiers blow up is, it's gonna be an explosion of damage. We could take the Devil Deal. Nah, let's take Angel Deal because Keeper's Bargain may screw us up. See, because we don't have enough money to possibly buy a Devil Deal item that I would want, so yeah. Let's take a look at this here boss rush. Oh my god. That's gonna be a spicy meatball. Yeah. A Monstro, Monstro 2 on the same one, huh? All right. Well, we didn't have to use the Stars card. I'm happy to say, happy to report. So the tier detonator is quite strong with Ipecac. As you saw, as that was a recent demonstration to show you in Boss Rush, you don't need a lot to make tier detonator really work for you. I mean, Ipecac is just going to wreak havoc on everything. I don't know where the Diglett is, but. Now imagine if we had the 9 volt. Super Seeking Room is going to be here. I don't think it's really going to matter, but. Pretty good run, I would say. We, you know, I mean, 163 damage. It's a typical run, you know? Okay, there we go. Got completely bamboozled by the direction of the Super Seeker room, I should say. Started watching. I don't know why. Maybe it's just because of the new movie, which I haven't seen, by the way. But I started going back and rewatching like Jurassic Park, and like basically HBO has the Jurassic Park trilogy on there. And you know, you watch the first one and I'm just like, man, it's just a masterpiece. Like, I've talked about it before on the Isaac episodes and on streams. Like, if an alien came down and was like, show me your perfect movie, like, what is a movie? Jurassic Park would probably be the perfect movie that I would show a species that has never seen the concept of a movie before. If not Jurassic Park, then probably Jaws, the original Jaws. Both of those would make excellent candidates for the perfect movie, I would say. So I hold Jurassic Park in very high regards, right? Watched the first one, loved it. I saw it in theaters. I was instantly captivated, and I wanted to just be a dinosaur. I wanted to be an archaeologist. And then, like, you know, I got a little bit older. So, and then, you know, Lost World came out, and, you know, and I started watching Lost World, and I never really thought about it before until I started watching it this week, I should say. Wow, we are just going in amazingly bad, like, wrong ways. It never occurred to me until I started watching it this time around, but Sarah Harding might be one of the worst characters that's ever been written. Ever. Like, and here's what I mean. just to give you an example of like of how dumb this character is, right? This Sarah, we're supposed to be made believe that this paleontologist is some. I mean, even John Hammond says to Ian Malcolm in the opening stages of the movie that, you know, okay. Anyway, when John Hammond's talking to Ian Malcolm, like saying like, you know, she's an expert, she's like the top of her field, she's leading the way, and you know she knows all about she knows all about like standing, you know, standing downwind from predators and blah blah blah. She worked with large predators in Africa, whatever. This woman, she in 10 minutes, they're talking about how incredibly talented she's an expert, top of her field, blah blah blah. And then like she starts talking about when she's first introduced in the movie, the importance is to observe and not interact, not interfere, blah 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 blah. But like the first thing she does is she reaches out and tries to touch a baby stegosaurus, and she touches it. It's like, come on, man. Like, you just got done saying how your entire team was there to only observe and not interfere with nature and blah, 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 blah. And then and then you just decide you're just going to reach out and try to touch a baby dinosaur when you just got done saying how, like, even bending a blade of grass could, like, screw things up. It's like, come on. You got to suspend some disbelief about this character, right? So, and then like I started cataloging in my brain just all the dumb things that this character is supposed to be, this wildlife expert who's been on safaris and studied large predators and stuff. But then she does something dumb like leave her jacket that had the T-Rex baby blood on there. What's his name? The hunter. Marble Man. I forget his name. I forget the actor's name. Great actor, but I forget his name. She even tells him, like, he asks her, like, are you injured? And she's like, no, it's just when I was setting the baby Rex's, the T-Rex's broken leg and whatever. And it's like, so you've got blood on your jacket. Like, what'd you think was gonna happen? You just got done saying in another scene how the T-Rex has, like, the best sense of smell outside of the turkey vulture. And then all of a sudden you're running around the jungle with the blood of the baby T-Rex on your jacket. It's like, man, there's some, like Jurassic Park 3, don't get me wrong, Jurassic Park 3 is horrible. It's a trash movie that should have never been made the way it was. But, like, you know, Lost World is not that much better. I had to go on that rant because there's nothing else to talk about right now because we got 231 damage. I mean, this run is just insane. Absolutely unbridled destruction. We don't even need blind rage. I don't know. That ruined a lot of what I enjoyed about Jurassic Park 2, which, by the way, I still maintain that one of, if not the greatest character in Jurassic Park history is Eddie. Is Eddie from Jurassic Park 2 from The Lost World. That character is more heroic and more insanely awesome than any other character that's been introduced in the Jurassic Park world. I'll firmly stand by that. Like, he does so much to try to save the main characters, which, I mean, spoiler alert for 1999's The Lost World Jurassic Park sequel, whatever. I mean, Sissy! How you doing, Sissy? Thank God we've got explosion immunity. Oh, no. We just got conjoined as well. Sissy! Oh, that's just great. Okay. Everyone's like, thank you, Sissy, for saving us from this Jurassic Park speak. No, listen, seriously, Eddie from Lost World is like the most heroic, amazing character in all of the Jurassic Park franchise. Even when he's got T-Rexes around him trying to eat him, he's still trying to hit the gas pedal on the Jeep to save the main characters when he knows he's going to not make it. I mean, it's absolutely incredible. And at least Malcolm, like, says, like, he gives him a nice little eulogy, like, you know, the man gave his life to save ours, you know. Look at, I mean, what is going on here? I don't know what the graphical fidelity is looking like on the bit rate, but it's got to be not happy. And can you even hear me at this point? This is just madness. I will take the soul of Esau if we end up fighting. Okay, never mind. Forgot we had more options. It's almost beautiful in a way, isn't it? That's instant death. Now let's see if Megastan fares any better than old Blue Baby here. Even after we got almond milk, our damage is still 69.17. Absolute bonkers. All right, Stanley. Well, good luck. You are absolutely going to need it. I mean, those shots haven't even hit the floor yet. Like, that's my reflection causing those delays. Oh, no. And every single shot, as soon as the tear detonator comes back up, will also spawn more shots. Yeah. And we ain't done yet. We're just getting tears up left and right now. It doesn't even matter. You get Quince as well if you're wondering where all those little brimmies are coming from. If I can get out of this door. Yeah, Jam Jar Boy is not he is not enjoying this episode. I can hear him now, he's being like, dang it, man. Dang it, Invicta. Trying to sleep. Okay, we went straight to Delirium. And he's dead, alright. Thank you for watching, everyone. Hope you enjoyed that. Remember, if this video gets to 8,000 likes, I'll be doing a very special run to commemorate the end of All Items Taken Week before Sunday. Thank you again, everyone. Thank you for liking, commenting, and subscribing. Happy Friday. Go have a great weekend for me. Do it for your old pals, Invicta. Thank you again, everyone, very much for the support on the Isaac series. And as always, I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody. Thanks for watching this video. I'd like to thank some patrons of mine like Steve with a Lisp, Efrain, Lysidius Dex Ludix, Nate Meldick, Brittany Conyers, and YT Kilroy. If you'd like to have your name read at the end of an Isaac episode, then check out my Patreon campaign, which you can find over at patreon.com/Sinvicta.